All right, so let's talk about how to graph a quadratic function. First of all, this is a quadratic function because I see that x is being squared. So it's the fact that x is being squared that makes this quadratic. So it's a quadratic function. And generally speaking, the graph of a quadratic function is a parabola. So you want to sort of look at a function and recognize right off the bat the general shape of it. Okay, so when we go to graph parabolas, what we do is we first look for intercepts. And the simplest intercept to find is the y-intercept. So anytime you're looking for a y-intercept for any curve that you're graphing, what you do is you let x be equal to 0 and then solve the resulting equation. So I'm going to take x, I'm going to take 0 for x and plug it right in. So I've got y is equal to x squared minus 2x minus 3. And if x is 0, now it's going to be y equals, well, 0 minus 0, right, minus 3. So y would just be negative 3. Okay, now that is my y-intercept. Y is negative 3. In other words, my parabola crosses the y-axis at negative 3. Now let's find our x-intercept, or intercepts. Now, as far as the x-intercepts are concerned, you may have none, you may have one, or you may have two for parabolas. So we're going to find this similarly to how we found the y-intercept. So instead of setting x to 0, for the x-intercept, we're going to set y to 0. So we take our equation, y equals x squared minus 2x minus 3, and we set y to 0. So it's going to be 0 is equal to x squared minus 2x minus 3. And you have to solve this quadratic equation. And the way you do that is by either factoring or using the quadratic formula. So in this case, we can factor. So this is going to be, let's see, well, x plus 1 times x minus 3. And that gives values of x to be negative 1 or x to be 3. Now what that means is that our parabola crosses the x-axis twice, first at negative 1 and then again at when x is 3. So we have two x-intercepts for our parabola. Finally, we're going to find what's called the vertex of the parabola, and then we'll go ahead and graph it after that. Now to find the vertex, what you do is you make use of a formula that gives you the x-coordinate. And the x-coordinate for the vertex is always equal to this, negative b over 2 times a. That's when your parabola is in standard form, where you have ax squared plus bx and then plus c. So in this case, let's see, well, negative b is negative 2 and a is positive 1. So it's going to be 2 times positive 1. And this is my x coordinate, right? So what do I get? Well, the negatives cancel, and 2 divided by 2 is 1, so x is 1. Now, the vertex is a point. It has an x-coordinate and a y-coordinate. So we found the x-coordinate, it's 1. To find the y-coordinate, we're going to plug x equals 1 into the function. So f at 1, what's that equal to? Well, it's going to be 1 squared minus 2 times 1 minus 3. So it's going to be 1 minus 2 minus 3, which is negative 1 minus 3, or negative 4. So the vertex for this parabola is at x is 1 and y is negative 4. Okay, so we have some points, right? We have the vertex, we have two x-intercepts, and we have the y-intercept. Let's go ahead and make use of that information and now graph this parabola. Okay, so there we go. The y-intercept is negative 3. The x-intercept is negative 1, or two x-intercepts, right? Negative 1 and negative 1 and positive 3. And the vertex is 1, negative 4. So let's go ahead and plot those points. Here's the y-intercept. It's where the parabola crosses the y-axis. The x-intercepts are positive 3 and negative 1. And the vertex is at 1, negative 4. That would be way down here. So this parabola opens up, and it looks like that. So let's go ahead and draw a curve parabola through these points. Okay, so the parabola is, you know, just projecting is going to go through maybe this point, and then that point, this point. And it's got some curve going on, right? Some curvature to it. Then it goes through this point, sort of like that. Then it comes up here, like so. And then finally, maybe up to this point here. Okay, so let's go ahead and draw a curve through these points. Okay, so there we go. There's our curve. This is a parabola. So it continues up, like so, and it comes in smooth, like that. Now you should know that this is smooth right here. This point, remember, is called the vertex. So that's the general shape of parabolas. They kind of look like U's, but they get wider and wider, and they're smooth at the vertex. Okay, so this parabola happened to open, we say, up, and it had two x-intercepts. Let's try another one like that. Let's graph f of x equals x squared plus 2x plus 2. So once again, we're going to look for our intercepts. So we're going to look for the y-intercept, and we're going to set x to 0 once again. So that gives us, well, I can see it's going to be y is equal to, okay, 0 plus 0, I get y is equal to 2. And the x-intercept, or intercepts, we'll see, we're going to set y to 0, and that gives me, well, the equation becomes x squared plus 2x plus 2 equals 0, right, when y is 0. Now, I can't solve this by factoring because I don't know how to factor that left-hand side. So whenever you want to solve a quadratic equation and you don't know how to factor it, you can always use the quadratic formula. So that's going to be, well, let's see, x is equal to negative b, so negative 2 plus or minus the square root of b squared, which is 4 minus 4, times ac. And a is 1 and c is 2. And so when I multiply those together, I get 2. And that's all over 2 times a, which is 2. So I get, let's see, it's going to be negative 2 plus or minus the square root of what? Well, 4, I have to multiply the 4 and the 2 together first. So 4 minus 8 is negative 4. And then all over 2, so I get x is equal to negative 2 plus or minus. Now, the square root of negative 4, whenever you have the square root of a negative, that generates an I, right? So it's going to be I times the square root of 4 all over 2. And then that's going to give me, well, let's see, x is equal to negative 2 plus or minus, well, the square root of 4 is 2, and 2 times I we write as just 2i, and then all over the 2. And so then I'm from the numerator. You don't want to cancel the 2's right here, or these 2's. You first want to factor that numerator. So it's going to be 2 times negative 1 plus or minus I all over 2. Now we can cancel, because 2 has been written as a factor. So the 2's cancel, and here we go. We get negative 1 plus or minus I. Now these numbers I can see involve I, and that means they are complex. Now when we say complex, that means that they're not real, that they're not real numbers. And for that reason, this parabola has no x-intercepts. And the reason that's true is because an x-intercept is where the parabola crosses the x-axis. But the x-axis contains real numbers. But there are no real numbers. So this parabola never crosses the x-axis. Okay, now to find the vertex, every parabola has a vertex. We're going to let x be negative b over 2a once again. So let's see, that means x is equal to negative, well, b is 2, and a is 1. So it's going to be 2 over 2 times 1. So we've got, let's see, negative, well, negative 1. Now to find the y-coordinate, just like before, I'm going to plug negative 1 in for x, and I get, let's see, f of negative 1 is going to be, well, negative 1 squared is 1, And then 2 times negative 1 is negative 2. And then plus 2. So I end up getting negative 1 plus 2, or positive 1. In other words, the vertex has coordinates x is negative 1 and y is positive 1. Okay, so we have the vertex, we have no x-intercepts, and we have the y-intercept of 2. So I only have 2 points, right? I have the y-intercept and the x-intercept, and the vertex with no x-intercepts. All right, let's go ahead and graph this and see what this leads to. Okay, so we have the y-intercept of 2, so we're way up here. And we have the vertex, negative 1, 1, right here. Now this parabola opens up. And so I can see that the parabola looks like this, and that's consistent with the fact that we have no x-intercepts. But what I do notice is this, is that recall that the vertex lies on the axis of symmetry. The axis of symmetry is a vertical line about which the right branch of the parabola, like that, looks like the left branch. Okay, so here's the logic. If you're at the vertex and you go over 1, I can see that you go up 1. Likewise, from symmetry, if you go left 1, you must go up 1 as well. And so I know this point has got to be on my parabola, right about there. Why? Because the vertex, you have symmetry about the vertex, right? So the left branch has to look just like the right branch. And if I continue, maybe draw one more point here to get a good idea how this graph is going to look. Maybe there and there. Okay, now I want to go ahead and draw a curve through these points. Let's do that. Okay. And our vertex, we come in flat right around there again. Okay, let's go ahead and sketch a curve through these points now. And there we go. So remember, our parabola continues up, and it's getting wider and wider in both directions. So let's go ahead and now look at the domain of this parabola. So the domain for any quadratic function, or for any polynomial function, is negative infinity to infinity. I can plug in whatever real number I want. And the range, well, where does y start? Y starts at 1 and goes on. So the range is going to be from 1 to infinity. Okay, so that's how you graph parabolas making use of plotting points. And as we see, sometimes parabolas don't have any intercepts at all. And we saw previously an example where the parabola had 2 intercepts. Can you imagine a case where a parabola had 1 intercept? Where would the vertex have to be for the parabola to have 1 x-intercept? I'll leave that for you to think about. All right, until next time.